It's time for Tech Time with Timmy.
Hello, welcome to Tech Time with Timmy. And so, Timmy's going to be talking about how to unzip or zip files on your Windows computer. So, zip files are really cool files where you can have multiple files inside the zip file. So, it's really handy if you want to send files to people, or maybe if you download a whole lot of files from Google Drive or Google Photos or any sort of cloud storage service, they will often come in a zip file. So, there's many reasons why you might have a zip file you want to open, or why you might want to create a zip file to send to someone. So in this episode, Timmy's going to show you how to unzip the file and how to create your own zip file on your Windows computer. So first of all, Timmy's going to show you how to open a zip file, because that's probably what most people will want to do. So to open a zip file, you'll just need to find your zip file. Timmy's got Timmy's one right here. And then just double click on the zip file, so hover the mouse over it and click twice. And now it will open up the zip file, and you can see all your files and you can view them and stuff, but you can't really do much to those files while they're in the zip file. You have to move them out of the zip file and then there'll be proper files on your computer. So click on the top file and hold down the shift key and click on the bottom file so that they're all selected. And then you'll just need to move them to anywhere that's not inside the zip file. So you can drop them onto your desktop, or you can put them in a different folder on your computer. And maybe you want to put it in the same folder as where your zip file was. So you can move it to wherever you want, as long as it's not in the zip file. So Timmy's going to move it into this Tech Time with Timmy's Demos folder up here. So just click and drag the selected files and drop them in there. And it might take a little while to copy them to the new place if you've got a lot of files or something. But if you don't have many files like Timmy, it'll be really quick. And then you can just go back to the location where you moved your files to. And as you can see, they're now all out of the zip file, and you can do whatever you want with them. They're just like any other file on your computer. So that's really cool. And now if you want to zip files into a zip file, you'll first need to get all the files into the same spot. So it can be on your desktop or on a different folder on your computer. So they just need to be in the same spot. If they're already all in the same spot, you can just skip this step. But if they're in different folders on your computer and stuff, you might want to consider creating a folder like Timmy did that says files to zip. And then you can put all of the files in there that you want to zip. And then you'll just need to open that folder, or just go to wherever your files are. And then once you've got all the files, you'll need to select them all. So you can do that in two different ways. One of them is if you click and drag from the bottom to highlight them all like that. And the other way is if you click on the top one, hold down shift on your keyboard and click on the bottom one. And now they're all selected. So you just need to get them all selected. And then you'll need to right click on one of the files. It doesn't matter which one, just any one. So right click on it and then come down to send to, and you'll get this little folder off the side that says, and on here will be compressed zipped folder. So just click on that and now it will zip them all up into a folder. If you've got a lot of large files or your computer's a bit slow, it might take a while, but Timmy didn't have many files, so it's been very quick. And it will come up with a name based on one of your files to name the zip file, but you can just change that to whatever you want. And then once you've typed your new name, just press the enter key on your keyboard. And now you've got your new zip file, which you can do whatever you want with. You can send it to people or upload it places. So that's really cool. And that's really all there is to it. And if you found value in this video, please consider clicking on the thumbs up button down below. And if you want to see more videos like this, click on the subscribe button down below and click on the bell icon next to the subscribe button to be notified every time Timmy releases a new video. So that's really all there is to it. And that'll be the end of this episode of Tech Time with Timmy.